Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Before we begin today's video, I want to say a quick thank you to everyone who has subscribed to the channel, liked our videos. We really appreciate all your support so far. You know, we're nearly at 700 subscribers, which honestly I could have only dreamed of just a few months ago. The feedback is that people are happy with my explanations of my videos, the format in which it's presented. And look, that's the way I like to learn, so I'm glad that there's other people that like learning the way I do. It just makes it so much easier when you can just cut straight to the point, and to the bare minimums in some cases is the best approach, because you can really get over convoluted when you've got too much information to work with. So today, in light and in fashion of everything that we've done so far, I want to try and keep this as brief as possible, because honestly, it's one of the quickest things I could probably teach you. If you've been following our Cloudflare videos and following our progress so far on setting up our virtual environment and our virtual home lab that we've been working with together, this is going to work in perfectly for you and our scenario. So I've had several people ask me to do something on Dynamic DNS, and we're going to keep it simple. If you're interested and you have used Cloudflare, followed our Cloudflare video to set up your domain, then this is for you. If you haven't used Cloudflare to set up your domain, this might still be an option for you. I'll leave that up to you, but I highly recommend checking out our Cloudflare video and seeing if it works for you. If it does, jump back in here after, and we're going to go on to the next step. So without further ado, let's get stuck into it. So guys, you're interested in Dynamic DNS. What is Dynamic DNS, you might ask? When we first set up our domain over in Cloudflare, we had to pick an IP address that was our public IP address, so that when someone typed in example.com, Cloudflare knew to send example.com to this particular IP address where the server is living. I'll show you that real quick. So here we are on Cloudflare, and if I just go into our domain, then to DNS, in this field right here, you will see an IP address. That's the IP address that you had to put in for your public IP address. It is a record, and it says the domain that you're trying to set up the IP address for. Then you have your subdomains that we've set up. So we've got one for Overseer, for example, proxy, IPA, etc., etc. You might have a lot more. And you're telling those subdomains to point to ibracorp.org, or they are a subdomain or alias of ibracorp.org. So overseer.ibracorp.org, for example. Usually you would see an IP address here. I've blanked it out because obviously for privacy, we can't have our IP address on there, but you will have your IP address on there. So just imagine what your IP address would be there, okay? The problem with this setup is that many people around the world don't actually have a static IP address. So your IP address that faces out to the world, especially in a home and internet environment, is dynamic. And it changes. It could change daily, it could change monthly. And the issue this causes is, obviously, this address that you've put in here, this IP address, will no longer be accessible if your IP address for the server changes, because Cloudflare won't be able to send your content to that IP address, or the request, I should say. What Dynamic DNS does is installs a client or an agent on this level here. Or in our case, it will be on the internal server. And that agent will actually continue to check what the IP address is and then go ahead and update the DNS entry on Cloudflare. So you have constantly the same IP address being transmitted between both locations. I've done a quick example here, a quick image for you, because honestly, it doesn't need to be complicated. Here's our Unraid server. We have all of our stuff installed on there. We have our router, and our router is what detects our external IP address given to us by our ISP or internet service provider. And Cloudflare has our A record for example.com, or in our case, ibracorp.org, with an A record with this IP address. So if our ISP changes our IP address, this will no longer work. This is basically a dud and just won't get us anywhere anymore. So by having a DNS agent here instead, this can communicate directly to Cloudflare and constantly update our IP address. Whatever's been passed on from here will constantly be fed back to Cloudflare for us. Now, there are some videos out there setting up DuckDNS, and to be honest with you, I've been using DuckDNS just up until this week, okay? No word of a lie, just this week. So this is not me saying that this is a better option than that. I will say it is a better option if you are using the Cloudflare setup that I have taught you. This is definitely the better way to go. But if you want to use the DuckDNS option, that still works with a Cloudflare setup. So if you are following Space Invader 1's videos, for example, guys, they still work, they're still applicable. And by no means am I saying that this is better than that. Without his work, I wouldn't have learned all this. But I'm saying that if you are using the Cloudflare setup, this is a better approach. The reason why is because it actually uses your container here with your API from Cloudflare so that it is logged in into your account and directly makes the changes to your DNS entry on the Cloudflare website. And it means it's automated, so you don't have to be involved at all. So let's get to the install and I'll show you how simple it is. We're now back on Cloudflare and you can see we've got our IBRACORP.org A record here. That's gonna ask you if you're sure you wanna delete this. We're gonna go ahead and click delete. And that's gone. You may also have another one called www. Guys, that's the same as seeing a subdomain here. If it's pointing to your IP address, get rid of it. So all we're left with is our subdomains that we've set up. Okay, now if you try to go to these, they obviously won't work because there's nothing to tell Cloudflare where your actual domain is living. That's fine, we'll just leave it at that for now. And now we head back to Unraid. You can see we've got Nginx Proxy Manager, Organizer and Overseer running. Head over to the App Store. Once you're in the App Store, type in Cloudflare. Now you're gonna see a bunch of different options and look, all of them have a similar or varying intention on what they do. But the one I can definitely guarantee for this video, for what we're doing, is just gonna be this one here by the Self-Hosters Unraid Discord repository. Click the install and you're going to be faced with this template to install it. I'll walk you through that really quickly. You can see there's not many fields here to complete. First thing you'll need to do, set your network type. If you are not using your bridge and using your own Docker network. In the email field, enter the email address of the account that you want to use. So in our case, then it's going to ask for your API key. Head back to Cloudflare. In the top right corner, you can see my profile. Click on my profile. Head to API tokens. Under global API key, click view. It's gonna ask you to enter your password for your Cloudflare account and do one of these stupid captures that ask you to pick from a bunch of images. And then click view. Once you see your API key, click to copy. It'll then copy the API key. We can then close this window. Head back to Unraid and enter that information here. This is a very sensitive piece of information, so make sure that you have it secure and that it's masked or that you don't leave it in your clipboard. For the domain, enter the domain. So in our case, it's IBRACORP.org. You can enter subdomains, but in our case, we're just gonna leave that, okay? But you can enter subdomains here, but as you can see, it's optional. Select whether you are proxying through Cloudflare. Now, if you're not sure, head back to Cloudflare. Head to your DNS. And you can see here that it's proxied, okay? if you're using Cloudflare, more than likely you will be using proxy because that is the main function of Cloudflare, to be honest with you. So head back here and Cloudflare proxy, we're going to say true. For the records, leave it as a record. Now that you've entered that information, hit apply. And just wait for that to install. Once it's done, you can close that, head back to Docker, and you'll see that the agent is now running, or the container is now running. We're back in Cloudflare now, we'll just refresh. And there you go. I know you can't see my IP address, but there is an IP address there and an A record that's been created. So that's created it for us. And I don't know what else to tell you guys, but that's pretty much it. You've just set up Dynamic DNS. That Dynamic DNS will continue to update your IP address with Cloudflare as soon as that changes. So anytime that changes, it will then update it here in Cloudflare. So you can always be sure that the IP address is the same between your home, business, wherever, and in Cloudflare, so that the two communicate harmoniously. The other thing is you're eliminating the extra third party such as DuckDNS. You know, why add that extra layer trying to set it up with DuckDNS when you can just have it communicate directly with Cloudflare, especially if you're using Cloudflare as your DNS provider. So that's pretty much it, guys. I said that it was going to be a quick one and I hope that that was. Really enjoyed showing you that. I would like to give a big shout out to one of my community members for showing me this in our Discord. So big thanks to Intel who joined our Discord and shared his findings with the community. And that just really helps the whole community out. So it's worth making these videos because it helps everybody out. So thanks to him and thanks to everyone else for your support. Your ongoing support is amazing. You know, we're really trying to hit that 1,000 subscriber mark. So please, if you like the work, give us a subscribe and give us a like and a big thumbs up. So thank you very much. I hope that was helpful and we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video. Cheers.